Based on some discussions I've been involved with, I'd like to present a simple plea as to why you should never do manual region analysis of cell cycle data in flow cytometry. And if you've got questions on this short little vid, my contact information is down here. Many of us have protocols set up on our respective instruments to acquire data that will be analyzed for cell cycle analysis. Forward, side, singlet, and I've got varying gating structures here. This one's on all events. This one is through the area and width plot. I'm not going to get into the weeds about when to use which and when not to. The data is relatively clean, so I would probably go with something like this. But the problem, and where cores have a problem, is when we see things, when we see users doing something like this. This may have been fine 30 years ago, but it is no longer accepted. It hasn't been accepted for quite some time. We strongly do not recommend this. And this is where you would take that cell cycle data, as shown here, and you would put regions for G1, G0, S, and G2M. The simple upshot is your core staff would prefer you simply didn't do this. We're going to talk about a couple of reasons why not shortly. Let's talk about the basics of cell cycle analysis. For many years, the region analysis had been used, but we no longer recommend it. In fact, we outright discourage it, and I'll show you why in a bit. The goal in cell cycle modeling software is to remove the subjectivity of this region analysis gating, and there are reasons for that, and I'll show you that in the next slide. For many years, ModFit, a DNA cell cycle analyzing program, was issued with nearly every analyzer BD sold just for this reason, because BD Fax Diva does not have the subroutines to do cell cycle analysis. But whether you use FCS Express, Flojo, or ModFit, grab onto any of those, stick with them for your analysis. Multicycle comes with FCS Express, and it's the one I'm going to be working with here. Here's a sample file that I have from the core, and I'm basically doing region analysis. I've got M1 for G1, G2, G1, G0, M2 for S, M3 for G2M. But, and FCS is really good about telling me where my bounds are, so I can try to accurately, OCD style, put these regions where I need them. And some of you might say, wait a minute, I'm not thrilled with this one. This margin could come in just a little bit, or maybe this one needs to go a little more to the left. Welcome to subjective region analysis. There's one reason we don't want you to do this. You get five learned cytometers, you might end up with five different, slightly different results. But here's the bigger problem. This is one. Yeah, okay, just for ballpark for one, that's okay, but I have 12 files. So I got 12 files now all laid onto this. Now, actually, I would need to have 12 separate histograms, of course. But what does this really mean? I have three manually placed regions, 12 files. It means I have 36 regions I need to manually position and make sure they're as accurate as possible. This is where this analysis starts to break down. Now, here's the first nail in the coffin as to why you should not be doing region analysis. Here is region analysis done on this file, and I take the same file, I put it through FCS Express Multicycle and let it generate the data, and I summarize it over here. Here's manual, the region, Multicycle through the software, and you can see some marked differences in the G1, G0, and S. I have also seen differences in the G2M as well, but the differences here are remarkable. And if you're looking at a large number of samples looking for a subtle difference, you're not going to get there with this. Secondly, there's another bigger reason why we advise against region analysis. This is data that was supplied kindly by Helen Fleising from Thermo Fisher, and I'm using it here and here as well. And the EDU FCS, and this is their BRDU analog kit, and the data is really, really nice. So I asked her for the four so that I could use it in a situation like this. Here is the region analysis of the same data. And then before I get too distracted, the BRDU originally came out in 1989. So this has been around for a bit. But here's the region analysis. I have this here, S, G2M, G1, G0 here. I come all the way up. These guys right here are the G1, G0. These are the G2M. What about these guys? What about these guys? They're in S. They're incorporating the EDU or the BRDU Alexa 488. They're actually in S phase, where the red dot is, all the way up here and all the way down here before they finally come into the G2M. What is this doing? This is taking the entire swath of events from here all the way up here and assigning them statistically to this M1 or G1, G0 in region analysis. That's the error. It's including cells that should not be included. Region analysis is assuming these populations are discrete and separate, and they're not. They're actually piled up in back of each other in looking at the data in this manner in a two-dimensional view. So all of this incorporation in here is wrong here. It's wrong here. Those numbers are also going to impact how this comes into play. This is the second nail why we don't want to see people doing region analysis. Let the cell cycle modeling software do it. In fact, the one file here, again, that's SUM 159, you see the spill in here? Follow the red dot, that spill in here. This is S. There are guys here in S that are still going to be counted in G1, G0. That's these guys. Same thing for over here. That's the spill in over here. And you'll actually see a little bit of G2M and a little bit of spill into from G1, G0, and that's fine. You got these little guys over here. All right. Let the model do the work. Now, I know there are other resources out there. I'm on DNA cell cycle analysis. Multicycle and FCS Express has 6 different models, and you're supposed to actually do your main control one, your main control file, and choose the model that has the lowest chi-square so the data is as clean as possible. That's what I do, and I will run, check it with the control, and then run all of the tubes in that experiment with that model. Don't run, if you got 12 tubes, don't run 1 through 4 with this model, and 5 through 7 with this one, and 8 through 12 with this one. No, just keep it all the same model. It's the best assumption you can make. You get reasonable data, good data, and hopefully that will take the subjectivity out of it and not misrepresent the different phases. All right, I thank you very much. Thank you very much for the time.